Okay, here's a little exercise to work on when your horse wants to rush back to the barn. Now, Mr. T here, he's been out in pasture. It's winter time. It's been raining. Hasn't been ridden in maybe a couple weeks, maybe 3 weeks. So he's got all his winter fur. He's been eating all his good green grass. He's been just standing around. It's been raining. And the first time the sun come out, I just want to get on him just a little bit. He was showing a lot of dominance and a lot of, I hate using that term disrespect, but he wasn't seeing me as a leader. He wasn't treating me like a higher horse. And like right now, he's trying to walk off and put his head up and say, hey, I want to walk away. I need to back up, pay attention to him. He needs to stand in the loose rein while I'm talking here. Drop his head and stand quietly. So, and I just did a video about setting a horse up to fail, where I kind of let him go. And now I've ridden him for, maybe 5 minutes, where I've given him good, strong direction. And he's calmed down. He's gotten his freshness out of him a little bit. I haven't ran to death. He hasn't sweat yet. He's walking in this mud, so he's breathing a little hard. But that's because he's walking through this thick mud, and he's having to pick his feet up, and he's carrying my fat butt. So what I wanted to cover a couple things while I'm riding in here. He just wanted to turn around and face that barn. The barn's behind us. I want him facing where I want, and I want him standing where I want. And when he tries to turn around, I'm going to back him up and make him feel uncomfortable. Say he wants to look to the right now, the barn's to the right. Now when he moves, he's going to move toward that barn because he wants to go get the saddle off, and he knows that when we're done, we walk back to the trailer and I take the saddle off. And because I don't want to get muddy. Normally I'd get off out here and get off in different directions. But I'm not going to get off out here and walk through the mud. He's going to carry me back. And he's kind of, see, there he goes, facing that barn. So I'm going to turn him away from that barn. I'm going to back him up. And I'm going to let him have a loose rein. And he's going to stand here on a loose rein. I'm letting him commit the mistake so he learns what I don't want. If I just fight and hang on to those reins and keep, see, he's looking at the barn. Look, he's looking back. He's like, oh, dude, there's a barn. If I can just get this guy not paying attention. Maybe he's talking on that phone. He's not paying attention. He is looking. His ears are coming to me, and he's seeing. He's feeling my body. He's reading me. Is he paying attention? And my timing is critical here, because if I let him slowly eat, and he'll take one step, and I go, well, that's one step. See, he just shifted his butt. He just shifted his legs. I thought he was going to move his butt to the right, which would move his head to the left toward the barn. He's looking, he's thinking, dude, man, he's not telling me not to go. If I can just get him back to that barn, he'll get off. I just know it. Horses are always thinking, and they're smart. I always get these letters. My horse is really smart. All horses are really smart. It's their job to be smart. They pay attention. If they don't, they die. It's instinctual to be smart. They pay attention to what's happening. They pay attention to you. So when you're screwing up, not paying attention, you want to say, oh, my horse is smart. That's why he's bad. No, he's bad because you're not paying attention and you're not smart. Again, all these blames on the horse, you can tell how much somebody knows about the horse when their horse does something and they immediately want to say, my horse is fresh. My horse is stubborn. He's a stallion. Oh, he's a thoroughbred. They're just hot bloods. Or he's an Arabian. Oh, they're just hot bloods. Oh, he's lazy because he's a draft. All these excuses are people that don't have a clue what the hell they're talking about. Horses are horses and they pay attention. And if you let them get away, if you give them 1 inch, they're going to take advantage of it. He's looking over there. He's like, come on, dude, maybe he's not paying attention. There he goes. Took one step forward. And I didn't correct it. See that one step? Took one step forward. Now, a few minutes ago, he did that and he had to pee, so I don't think he has to pee again. I thought he might have been parking out earlier because he just peed, but he just peed 5 minutes ago, so I can't imagine him having to pee again. So he might have just wanted to get his stance a little bit better. But you notice now that I'm sitting here, I corrected him a couple times. He's on a loose rein. I'm not stopping him from going back to the barn. I'm not fighting him. I'm not using the bit. I'm not showing him who's boss. What I'm doing is when he faces or wants to go to the barn, I make him uncomfortable. I make him back up. I make him face away, and then I give him loose rein. And when he stands here with his head down, I leave him alone. My hand's quiet. I'm not moving my hand. I'm not fiddling with the reins. There's a lot of nervous riders, and they get, he just took a step forward. And normally I'd back him up. God didn't. He turned, and here he goes. He's like, he ain't paying attention. That was so predictable. Back up, boy. So predictable. Now I'm going to let him face the barn. And now watch. When I give him loose rein, he's going to stand. There he goes. One step. So we're going to back up. I'm going to give him that loose rein. He's going to drop his head. Because he's facing the barn, I've increased that draw. Now he sees it. He's like, dude, it's just right there. If I can just get him, maybe if I lower my head, let me give him a couple seconds and he won't be paying attention. My hand's loose. Here he goes. He's about to take a step. I felt his body. He leaned. I didn't correct him. When I pick these reins up, he can tell when I take the slack out of these reins. And he knows. And as soon as he takes that step, I have to have timing and correct him. There he goes. Boom. One step. I didn't do it. Another half step. Didn't do nothing. He's like, oh, he's not paying attention. I got one. Now I'm going to take another step. Oh, now I'm going to take another. Oh, he doesn't have, he's not paying attention. Hell, he ain't driving. I'll drive. Oh. Now, did he learn that I didn't want him to walk off? No. He learned to walk off because I let him. Because I didn't anticipate on that one step and correct him. And that's what people do. I'm going to face him away from this barn to take away that drive a little bit. Oh. Now the barn's behind him. Now he's got to turn. Oh. Now he's got to turn around. He's on a loose rein, my hand soft, he's dropping his head, and we're just going to sit here. And he's learning patience, but he wants to look. Buddy's over there where he's looking too, so he's looking at Buddy. He's looking at the pasture. He's looking at the barn. He wants to go get the saddle off, and I don't blame him. He's got all his hair. The saddle pad's probably hot. The sun's out. He wants to be out here being a horse. I don't blame him. If I was a horse, I wouldn't want some fat ass sitting on me, trying to ride me, tell me what to do, and be my boss. I want to go out to with my horse and my pasture mates where I'm boss, where I know the rules, where I can relax, where I don't need to have somebody sitting on me telling. There he goes, leaning. There he goes. One step. Didn't correct him. Two steps. Here we go. We're going back to the barn. Stop him. Turn him, face him away from the barn. And ho. And the loose rein. And he drops his head. If he wants to get a snack, he can have a snack. Nope. See? He wanted a snack to get a looser rein there. Now, that time I corrected him early because I don't want to teach him too bad. He's dropping his head. My hands are loose. He's looking. He's looking. He's thinking. Okay, maybe he didn't correct me. Birds over here flew and kind of distracted him. He's like, what's going on? These birds are dive bombing over here. And he's like, what's going on? So that distracted him from the barn a little bit. You notice his head kind of looked up. His head went high. Reading your horse. Watching all this. Ears. Here he goes. One step. Didn't tell him no. Two steps. Didn't tell him no. He's off. He's on his own. Now I'm going to have to fight, pull, stupid horse. I told you to stand, get all mad, start correcting him, doing the seesaw and shit with the bit hurting the horse's mouth because he didn't listen. He didn't listen because I didn't give him direction. If you don't give him direction, you have to correct him. I'm going to give him direction, pick up those reins, tell him not to walk off. I didn't have to correct him. He's dropped his head, the reins are loose. He wants to head back to the barn. He's ready to head back to that barn. I have to be able to read his body the second he heads back and stop him. So, kind of what I wanted to do, he kind of got me on, here goes, one step. See, I let him take a step and a half. Now he's going to back up a step and a half. I'm going to give him the loose reins. He has to learn to stand on a loose rein. There's nothing worse than seeing a rider that never gives their horse loose reins because they want to make you think how tough their horse is to ride and how good they are because they can ride it. Oh, no, I can't give my horse loose reins. He's too strong-willed. He used to be a stallion. He's the lead horse out there. Oh, no, he's too used to being in charge of last owner. I sent him to trainer, and they didn't train him good, so I got to keep the reins tight and control my horse's head. Back up. Now, I don't care if you want to toss your head. Back up, boy. Took that step forward, back up a step. You want to dance? We'll do the moonwalk and Michael Jackson all the way across his barn. If he wants to back up, by gosh, we'll do it. But if he stands still on a loose rein, then he gets to stand still and relax. And you want to take a step? He's going to back up. And you need to be consistent. I have to do this. I do this every time with Mr. T. But he's going to test me just like today. He's filling his oats. I haven't ridden him a lot. He's not real tired. I haven't worn him out to where we haven't been out on a three-hour ride to where he's a lot more compliant. He's a lot more like, man, I don't have the energy to fight this dude. So he's still a little high energy. So he's going to keep testing me. This isn't being mean or bad. Don't take it personal. This is a horse being a horse. Mr. T wants to go back to where I'd want to go if I was a horse. Understanding that will stop you from getting into all these other crazy crap that people are out there telling you, show that horse suit, boss. Make him stand still. He doesn't respect you. Get off him and lunge him. You got to wear him out. Put him in that round pen and run him in 400 circles till he's sweating and then he's too tired to fight you. That's what you need to do to that stupid horse. No, you need to learn to understand your horse. You need to learn to understand that they're a horse, and they're going to try and they're going to test because that's what they do. And he wants to go back there, and I picked up those reins when he looked that way, so he didn't move. But he wants to move. I can feel his body shift. I'm picking up those reins, and we're backing up. The quicker I let him know that I know what he's up to, the quicker he'll stop, and he'll learn to stand. Because I'm talking to you, and I let him get away with it a few times, he moved that step, and I picked those reins up. Because I let him get away with it a few times, he thinks I'm not paying attention. So he's going to try it more. Had I corrected him on the first one and not let him get away with it, not once, he would not be doing what he's doing now. But I'm letting him get away with it. I'm showing you how quick a good horse can turn into a bad horse if you don't know what you're doing. If you allow him to do things that he shouldn't be doing. Now, when I started this, I wanted to walk him along this rail here. So we're going to walk off here. and he walks faster going this way than he does the other way. So I want you to look at his cadence, look at his head. We're in the same mud. He likes to get close to this fence. Horses like this fence. They feel comfortable when they get by a fence. Watch this horse as he's running. His head's high. We're heading back to the barn. He's like, yeehaw, I got this energy. I got this drive. I just can't help myself. And I'm getting excited talking on his phone because I'm trying to make a point, and he feels that. And now he wants to trot. We're almost to the barn. I got him going. Oh, shit, he turned me the other way. Damn. Now he's got his depressed mode. Now he's like, damn, stupid human. He's got my number. And now we're going to walk on a loose rein. Head's lower. He's walking a little slower. He was walking slower before I was talking on his phone. But his head's low, and he's walking slow, and he's got a good walk to him. And this is the way he should be walking, because we're going away from the barn. He don't want to go this way. Notice how he's getting close to this thing? I tell people, people that don't know what they're doing, when a horse gets loose, they always run to the fence. That's the dumbest place to be. If a horse gets loose and he's running crazy, something's dragging on him, and there was an accident and the horse is running around panicking, last place I want to be is next to a fence, because that's where horses are going to go. They're going to run along this fence. You know, I'm not telling Mr. T to walk by this fence, but he keeps moving closer and closer because he finds comfort by that fence. He's looking for an opening in that fence so he can get out. He's learned from being a domesticated horse that if I follow a fence, sooner or later there's going to be a gate and I can get out. Hey. Now I started not paying attention. He's wanting to trot off. Well, I'm getting knot in his ass. Knock it off! Now, I'll let him get away with a few things on this video, but he ain't going to just start stinking trotting off on me when I'm not trying to make a point. Look how low that head is. Look how submissive. That's on a loose rein. He ain't looking at that barn now because he heard the tone of my voice that I ain't playing. All right, now I know. You're a good boy. All right, it's over. I can't stay mad. I can't stay upset. I'm going to have him walk off. And again, I'm setting this horse to fail because I'm talking on his phone. He hears me talking, and he doesn't know. That head's way too high. Knock it off. Because I've let him, and that's the problem with Mr. T, you let him take an inch, and he'll take a mile. Back up. So we're going to do some back up. Knock it off. And he don't like backing up because that takes a lot of energy in this mud. His feet are sinking deep. Now that head's nice and low, and now he's like, okay, I guess he's paying attention. Maybe I won't mess with him. Maybe just because he's talking on that phone, I shouldn't ignore him. I know, you're a good boy. Dad still loves you. Even though I'll beat you in the head, he still loves you. Pay attention to your horse. Make sure you know what he's doing and why he's doing what he's doing. And again, back to that fence thing, the safest place to be when a horse is dragging and scared is in the middle of the biggest open area you can. Because the horse is trying to avoid you. He's scared. He's not going to run by a predator. He's not going to run over you. He's not going to run to you. But what people do is they run by the gate, they run by the fence, and they try to hide by the fence. That's exactly where the horse goes. He ends up trampling and running over, and then you got some idiot in the stand saying, that horse attacked that person. Did you see that? That person wasn't doing anything. He was by the fence and that horse just ran right over to him and trampled him. No, he didn't, dumbass. He ran because he ran by the fence and a stupid human ran in front of him and he took the path that the horse is going to do. If you stand in the doorway when a horse is panicking, you're going to get knocked down. And I can't tell you the number of people that have gone to the doctor and the ambulance comes and I'm sitting there watching them going, what a dumbass. They jumped in front of the horse and raised their hands in the air like they were going to stop a 1,200-pound animal because somebody told them that if you get big and raise your hands, a horse won't run over you. So they tried it. And they got their ass knocked down. And now they're looking at an ambulance. And they're laying from a gurney looking up. And what are they saying? Yeah, that horse is really crazy. He attacked me. He charged me. That horse is out of control. That horse was running from his life. He's being a horse. And you got in his path. And if you're dumb enough to get in front of a path, why don't you go play in a highway and get in front of a 1,200-pound vehicle and see if it stops? Because a horse, when they get scared and they're panicking, you need to be smarter than them. And you don't want to get in their path. And their path is along a fence line or out a doorway or out of an escape path or to a gate. And if you get in that area and think because you raise your hands because you saw it in a clinic or you saw some dude do it and you think that's getting big enough to stop a scared horse, well, then I'll be talking to you at the ambulance or at the hospital and you can post on your Facebook. I'm at the hospital because a crazy horse ran over me. And then I'll put a comment. Maybe the crazy person got in front of the horse. Okay, so that's working on your horse. And Mr. T, I went off on a tangent on when I hear people blaming horses, it just irritates me. So I hope that helps in understanding. Mr. T, you notice, has been standing here. He ain't taking one step. He ain't moved. He's been on a loose rein because I got in his butt and I made him back up. I showed him that I was paying attention. I gave him direction. I gave him good direction so I don't need to correct him. And that's how you control a horse and work and establish dominance. Hope that helps. Mr. T, you're a good boy even though I had to beat you.